Please ask everyone to rise as our beautiful bride is about to join us. I want you to go ahead and take a step forward, and you two can go ahead and welcome each other to each other's families. You can have a hug or a high five. Stir up some love out here. Go ahead and give them a big hug.
There we go.
Yes. And Jackson, I want you to put their hands together.
Perfect.
Thank you. And then I want the two of you to come in closer. Go ahead and pass your bouquet. And everyone, you may go ahead and be seated.
You can get to have the two of you just kind of get centered in the aisle. Move towards your guests just a little bit. Perfect. And back if you can. Mm-hmm. Just a little. Perfect.
Family and friends, I want to welcome everyone to this beautiful wedding day in paradise. We may have sacrificed just a little bit of sun for today, but instead we have dolphins. And we have beautiful weather and a nice breeze to make this so comfortable. And before we actually get started, I want to just say a quick little bit about when it rains on your wedding day. When I first moved here, I thought that was quite a lame excuse to tell a couple like yourselves that have traveled so far and waited so long that want a beautiful sunny day on the beach, but it is actually good luck with good reason. Today's weather outside just reminds us that we will be weathering many storms in throughout your married lives together as a couple. We can't control the weather, just like we can't control our moods or how we're going to wake up and love each other each day. But the good news, however, is that the rain comes in and it blesses. It washes away all the negative energy, and it's a rebirth of everything new and wonderful. So having said that, today our hearts are filled with great happiness as we come together to celebrate one of life's greatest moments. We are about to witness the joining of your two souls, very, very much in love, the unconditional love that you both share. Today the promises that you will make will bind your hearts and solidify this bond in your lifetime commitment as you are about to be united in marriage. So on behalf of our bride and groom, I first of all want to just thank each and every one of you, family and friends, that are here today to celebrate. I know that you've taken time out of your busy lives. Many of you have traveled a great distance to be here, but it means the world to them that you are here to uplift them with your love and support of their marriage. Because your being here today is truly the greatest gift that you could have given our bride and groom on their wedding day. In these uncertain times that we are currently faced with, I'm sure that you will all agree that we have been reminded what is truly important, and that is our families. And today, we are all one amazing, loving family. And as we move forward in an attitude of love and gratitude, I would like to ask for God's blessings over the ceremony and your marriage. So if I could ask everyone to please just bow their heads in prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we first give thanks to you for allowing us to come together this beautiful afternoon as we honor the love and commitment between Frank and Amy. Lord, we are so grateful for your presence with us here today and for your divine blessings over the ceremony. Father, the love between a man and woman has always been one of your richest and greatest gifts to the world, and today we celebrate that love. We ask that you will bless Frank and Amy with a long-lasting, loving, and beautiful marriage. Bless their families and friends, Lord, and the relationships which have supported, strengthened, and sustained them throughout their lives. And we pray this in your name, Heavenly Father. Amen.
Amen.
So Frank and Amy, we finally made it. It's October the 4th, your long-awaited perfect wedding day. And wow, didn't you pick a great year to get married? It's the start of a new decade, and of course you're being married in the midst of a global pandemic, and I don't know if that's something to brag about or complain about or whatever, it is what it is. But obviously it's a time when history is being made, and obviously the world is a much different place than what it was when you first started your wedding planning. There were a few hiccups along the way in having to reschedule your wedding celebration, but I'm sure you will agree, everything is perfect and it unfolded exactly as it was supposed to. So there is just an interesting fact that I'd like to share with you about being married in 2020 that you may or may not be aware of. According to numerology experts, they state that despite COVID and every other strange thing that's happening this year, this is still the best year in the decade to be getting married. When it comes to love matters, the number 2020 is a powerful symbol of love, trust, and faithfulness. Being married this year also indicates empowered commitments, emotional stability, and fulfillment of sacred contracts. Getting married and committing your lives to one another is obviously the most sacred contract that you could enter into. And that said, the two of you are obviously in for a lifetime of love and happiness. So today, as we stand here at this beautiful altar in the sand, I would like the two of you to reflect for just a few moments on your love story. I want the two of you to just think about all the experiences, the adventures that you've shared in this time together, and the memories that you've already made as a couple. So I want you to think back to that first time that you met, on that beautiful first date that you enjoyed on February 13th, 2019. Something magical happened on that first date. The chemistry between the two of you was incredible, and it was undeniable. You learned how much you share in common, but also that you respect and admire all the unique differences of each other as individuals, and that's what you fell in love with also. You're both very adventurous. You love to travel. You're amazing parenting partners. You both have a great sense of humor, which keeps the relationship fun and exciting. And the two of you fell in love with the very reasons that everyone here loves about the two of you. And that's the fact that you both have kind, warm, loving, and genuine hearts. You quickly learned that you had found far more than a best friend, partner, or lover. You did, in fact, find the one. You found your soulmate. So I want the two of you to just think about your friendship and your relationship and how far you've come in this time together that has brought us here today. And your love for one another now is unconditional and immeasurable. Frank and Amy, today you are about to make some very special promises to one another. As the two of you set out to embark on this new journey together as husband and wife, you have a vast and unknown but beautiful future that stretches before you. Today, you will carry the most respected titles that a man and woman can share as you officially become husband and wife. And as you create this new milestone in your lives, continue to seek and experience joy and happiness, but do it by continuing to grow together as a team, as a couple. May you bear one another's weaknesses, but grow from each other's strengths. Do things for each other not because of duty or sacrifice, but do it in the spirit of joy and of love. As you both know, there will be times in your marriage that you'll be faced with overcoming obstacles, facing challenges, fighting to be together and holding on like you are right now and never ever letting go. You also know that love is a lot of work, but it's realizing that every hour, every minute, and every second will be worth it because the two of you are in this together. So continue to be that partner that wants this marriage to be as loving, romantic, and amazing as it is right here, right now, on your wedding day. Frank and Amy, as you both know, marriage is the promise between two people who love each other deeply as the two of you do. You trust in that love, you honor each other as individuals, and you've chosen to spend the rest of your lives together. So are you ready to walk down this path as husband and wife and live together in the covenant of faith, hope, and love?
Yes.
We want to hear that really loud.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. Having said that, and now that you have publicly stated that you are ready to move forward in this lifetime commitment, we are going to go ahead and move forward with the giving and receiving of the wedding rings. So I'm going to ask you to come forward with that heavy responsibility.
You still have them?
No hole in the pocket. And go ahead and present them with each other's ring.
Perfect.
Thank you. As you both know, the wedding rings that you hold today are a symbol of your commitment and love for one another. May they remind you that marriage is not a destination, but it's a journey that has no beginning and no ending. May the precious metal of these rings that you hold today always remind you of your precious commitment to one another. And with these rings, may he who gives it and she who shall wear it remain faithful to one another and abide in peace and favor and live together until your lives end. So Frank, I want you to look into the eyes of this beautiful young lady that stands before you today and realize she is about to become your wife. She will look to you for gentleness, for support, for understanding, for encouragement, and for protection. Frank, do you receive Amy to be your wife, and do you give this ring as a symbol of your faithfulness and love as you join your life with hers from this day forward?
I do.
You may go ahead and place the ring on her finger. And Amy, as you look into the eyes and heart of this wonderful man that stands before you today, realize that he is about to become your husband. He also will look to you for gentleness, for support, for understanding, for encouragement, and for protection. Amy, do you receive Frank to be your husband, and do you give this ring today as a symbol of your faithfulness and love as you join your life with his from this day forward?
I do.
You may go ahead and place the ring on his finger. And as you hold hands, I want you to look into each other's eyes and hearts, as you will soon acknowledge some very important promises to one another. So I'm going to go ahead and state these promises, and I will have you acknowledge with a response at the end of each one. Frank and Amy, as best friends and partners, do you promise to trust and respect one another, be kind and patient with each other, support and encourage each other throughout your marriage, and accept each other unconditionally?
I do.
I do.
And Frank and Amy, do you promise to always be open and honest with one another, comfort one another in times of sorrow, laugh and cry together, grow in character and wisdom with one another, and cherish each other for as long as you both shall live?
I do.
I do.
Wonderful. Frank and Amy, you have just sealed your relationship with the giving and receiving of the wedding rings, and you have shared heartfelt promises. We are now going to move forward in celebrating your union as a couple and as a complete loving family with the meaningful tradition of the blending of the sands in the Unity Sand Ceremony.
So at this time, I'm going to move out of the way and have the two of you and invite Jackson.
Jackson, we are going to include you in this part of the ceremony. You are a very important part of it, so I'm going to ask you all to just stand in behind the table. This symbolic tradition will honor the two of you and your wonderful son, Jackson, through the blending of the sand. So I'm going to invite you to go ahead. Frank, if you wouldn't mind to remove the cork from the center container. And then each of you can go ahead and hold your individual containers. The separate containers of sand that you now hold represent your lives up to this moment, individual and unique. And in a moment, you will pour your sand into the center container. You will be merging your lives into a loving and supportive marital community. So Frank and Amy, I invite you to go ahead first and pour your sands into the center.
Oh.
No, in the jar, yeah.
It's messy, just like marriage is often, so it's okay. And if you can, there we go. Go ahead and blend them. Yes, it might need a little help. Perfect. And I'll have you leave just a little bit. And Jackson, I now invite you to go ahead and pour your container of sand over your parents. And we see that these grains of sand merge with both Frank and Amy, where they will be nurtured and protected. Now I'll ask the two of you to go ahead and pour yours over your son.
Do I need to leave some?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
If you can fill it up, that's great.
Why don't you go ahead?
Go ahead.
Mm-hmm.
Perfect. Jackson, if you want to top it off, mm-hmm. It's yours.
Just as these grains of sand can never be separated and poured again into their individual containers, so will your marriage and your family be joined as one forever in a union of love and of trust. Thank you. I invite the two of you to go ahead and stand again in front of the altar. Thank you, Jackson. So Frank and Amy, I'm going to ask you to do the most difficult thing you're going to do on your wedding day. I want you to take in a deep breath and relax. I want you to capture this moment. It's been a busy week. It's been a busy day. But this is your wedding day. God blessed you with the most incredible. It quit raining just for us for this time. But I want you to realize that right now you're creating a lifelong memory for the two of you, for Jackson, and for all of us that get to be here to celebrate these special moments with you. And right now, I want you to look into each other's eyes and just realize that the greatest gift that you've ever been given or received is standing before you today on your wedding day. And realize that these are the hands that you're holding today of your very best friend that is strong and full of love for you on your wedding day. These are the hands that will give you strength when you truly need it the most. And lastly, these are the hands that even as you grow old together will still be reaching for yours, still giving you that same unspoken tenderness with just one touch. Frank and Amy, your lives are now joined infinitely and inseparable as one because the two of you have committed yourselves to one another in marriage. May your union be forever, forever blessed. And therefore, by the authority vested in me, by the laws of the state of Florida, I now pronounce you husband and wife, and I invite you to seal this union and these promises of love with the most important kiss of your life. Go ahead and kiss your beautiful bride. She is now your wife. Wow, that was a little too fast. That you had more vows to seal. That was way too fast. That is not how that kiss goes. So we're going to give you one more try at that. Yes, you want a good kiss. Family and friends, please join our newlyweds in celebrating. They are married. Let's congratulate and celebrate.
Thank you all.
And go ahead and cast the bouquet.
Thank you.
groomer and mother of the bride. Please welcome Dean Barton and Sydney Barton. Next we have Jackson Stockbarger.
Obviously, we never thought this was going to happen, right? Never. So obviously, he's found the right woman. She's beautiful. This is a great day. I want to thank everybody for coming out and spending this day. And I want to welcome Amy and Jackson and Mater to the family. And we're just so thankful that Amy has a son with all the toys that Frank has. He now has somebody to play with. So... Everybody, Let's congratulate Frank and Amy on their big day. Let's eat, drink, and be merry.
Gotta cut the whole.
Don't worry about it, all those. No, I mean the gate. The bottom part.
Yeah, yeah, I don't know. I'm not sure. I think they just keep it flat.
The bottom.
Did it?
Yeah. Say yes, say yes, cause I need to know. Say you'll never get the blessing to the day I die. Love my friend, but the answer is still no. Why you gotta be so rude? Don't you know I'm human too? Why you gotta be so rude? I'm gonna marry her anyway. Marry that girl. Marry her anyway. Marry that girl. No matter what you say.
Something you try.